TalkBack 13.1 came out with a lot of great updates, like having actions within the reading controls, having spell check, split tap typing, more Braille display support, and a lot of other things. So let's go over all these updates. Hi everyone, welcome to Carry On Accessibility, where I talk about accessibility and technology. If you're interested in that type of video, hit the subscribe button and the bell. I'm pretty happy about this update. I think the best update is the actions in reading controls. When I say reading controls, that's when you can swipe up and down with three fingers and it takes you to different, what you can call granularities, or kind of like the rotor on iPhone, so.
Words, paragraphs. Headings.
There you go. And if I swipe up,
paragraphs, words, characters.
For older models that don't have multi-finger gestures, that would be a two-part gesture, a swipe up and down, or a swipe down and up.
Hide screen, speech rate.
Like that. Now, if an item has an action, you can just swipe up and down and double tap for an action. If it sounds familiar, it probably is, because it's very similar to VoiceOver. Though a little bit different. For example, here, I'm on the Play Store. If I swipe up,
add to home screen.
It says add to home screen. Swipe up again. Move item.
Shortcuts and notifications.
Shortcuts and notifications.
Activate.
Activate.
Add to home screen.
Add to home screen.
Move item.
Okay, let's try move item. I'm gonna double tap.
Remove. Double tap to activate. Move to row 2, column 1 in home screen. Move to row 2, column 2. Move to row 2, column 3 in home screen 1 of 1.
Just move it here. So using the actions, I was able to move it. One of the places where this is really great is the recent apps. So if I go to
recent apps, Gmail, Google Play Store,
here's the Play Store. I can just swipe down and double tap on close.
Task close. Gmail.
And it closes. Unlike the iPhone, you do have to swipe down again each time before you double tap. This also works in Gmail.
Google Pixelbook. Welcome to your new Pixelbook Go. Get started in
3
simple
steps. If I want to delete this,
delete.
I can just swipe up. Double tap on delete.
Carrie Morales.
Overall, I think this works really well. The only thing is it's limited by the developers and what they program as actions. In the past, developers haven't really used actions all that much because first TalkBack didn't have it, then it was kind of hard to get to. Hopefully developers will be able to add actions to their apps in future. The next change is how to change accessibility volume versus media volume. If you want to change accessibility volume, you're going to have to place one finger on the screen and raise and lower the volume. So right here,
Gmail. Accessibility volume set to 85%. Double tap to activate.
I have my finger on the screen and I can now control TalkBack's volume. I think it was sort of challenging before, where you had to wait for TalkBack to stop talking before you can change the media volume or vice versa. Also, this now is supposed to allow you to be able to use the volume buttons for different apps like the camera or button mapper and other apps like that. In the previous TalkBack update, we were able to switch between different windows using four fingers swiping up and down. Now we can do the same thing with four fingers swiping left and right to go to the next or previous container. Whereas the window will take you from maybe the app to the top bar to maybe the volume section of the screen, or like the accessibility buttons, things like that. Containers will take you to another part of the app. For example, here I am on YouTube. If you go to the shorts shelf,
amazing CMY color cube, more action.
You could just keep swiping to the right.
Missed more actions. I am blocked. More actions. The designer. More actions.
Now, if you want to kind of skip to the next section and not have to go to every single short, you can just do a four-finger swipe to the right.
Team viewer called me again. 4 minutes, 26 seconds. Go to channel. LMG clips 409.
Now it took you to the next container, next section. It kind of just depends on how they develop the app and how they program it and code it. But this took me off of the shorts shelf and to the next video. I find this really helpful for jumping between different sections of an app, and yeah, if you get stuck in some kind of big list, this is how you can get out. They also updated hide and show screen, which I am so glad about. So if I do a voice command, I can say hide screen.
Screen hidden. Do gesture tab with three fingers to open TalkBack menu. Highlight, show screen, then double tap.
It no longer has that 3-minute message saying that the screen is hidden, and this is amazing. Probably the first time that you turn hide screen on, it will still alert you about that. The only thing is that it still shows the TalkBack menu, so I'm going to tap with three fingers.
TalkBack menu. Actions. Enlist.
You can still see the TalkBack menu and also granularity words, controls.
Lines. Paragraphs.
Or reading controls. So I'm waiting for them to make sure that hide screen really does hide everything on your screen instead of still showing certain things, which if you want privacy, you want everything to be hidden. Just like on the iPhone and on the computer when you hide the screen with a screen reader. The next update is split tap typing. This is a new way to type. You use one finger that you can drag around the screen and another finger can tap on the screen to enter that letter. And so you don't need to double tap and you don't need to lift your finger. So here I have a new note in Google Keeps and let's try to type something. So let me see if I can do this. I'm going to try to show you split tapping. And so I'm going to
capital
H hotel. And then this is with my right hand, and with my left hand I'm going to tap on the screen once.
Capital H R Romeo E Echo.
And then I'm going to do the same
L,
thing.
Lima L L O O.
And then I can even
space.
Press space.
Hello.
There we go. And one great thing I really like is I can find delete. The delete, and I can just tap.
Capital H deleted.
And it will erase that way. Next update is spell check or text suggestions are now available using TalkBack and through the action. So let's see, what can I type here? Let's try to misspell hello. So I've mistyped hello on purpose. And so I should be able to use the three finger swipe up and go to a different reading control called Spellcheck.
Spellcheck.
And now I can swipe up and down for its suggestions.
No misspelled word is found. Hello.
Oh, there we go.
No misspelled word is found. No misspelled word is found.
Oh, great. Okay, so I just figured out that Spellcheck kind of moves the cursor, which is interesting. But another way to do this is actually through actions.
Characters. Actions.
Here we go. And I can swipe down.
Hello. H-E-L-L-O. Spelling suggestion. H-Hello. H-H-E-L-L-O. Spelling suggestion.
And it will give me the spelling suggestions there.
H-Hello. H-E-H-E-L-L. Move cursor to beginning. H-Hello. Hello. H-E-L-L-O. Spelling
and
suggestion.
And so here's the one I want. So I'm going to double tap.
Text replaced.
And it should replace the text. I like that there is now the text suggestion. I just found it slightly hard to use and a little bit buggy. I'd love to see where they go forward from here, and hopefully they can make it a little bit easier to use. The last update I'm going to talk about is Braille support. There, you can now use TalkBack with more Braille displays. I can't really speak too much about this. I would love to have a Braille display, but I currently don't. There are new Braille displays that this is compatible with. They are working with their Braille support, which is very much needed from what I have heard from Braille users. In one of the last updates, we got Braille screen input for Android, and that was pretty nice. I actually think potentially it can be much faster than typing on the keyboard, the QWERTY keyboard on screen. Still kind of challenging for me. I'd still much rather a QWERTY physical keyboard. I'm personally much faster with that, but I know for Braille users out there, it is definitely a lot easier than trying to type on a touchscreen. In a previous update on TalkBack, there was a new icon detection as well as being able to describe images. The describe images is kind of misleading. You go to an image that doesn't have alt text. If it has text in that image, you can bring up the TalkBack menu. You can double tap on describe image and it will do its best to read that image. It doesn't really describe the image like that has people and things like that. It's not alt text. It's more like OCR for the image. For icon detection, you do have to go to the TalkBack settings and download the icon pack file that helps TalkBack identify icons that don't have labels. I believe I touched on that with my Samsung One UI 5 update video. Pixels have a toggle where you can turn that on and off, whereas Samsung does not have a toggle for it, which is disappointing, which leads me to Samsung, the frustration with Samsung. They no longer have their own screen reader and they're using TalkBack, but the problem with Samsung is that they're not using Google's TalkBack. They have to have their own TalkBack in the Galaxy store, and it is so frustrating. Samsung devices aren't able to use these new features of TalkBack, which I think are super helpful, because Samsung needs a couple months, hopefully it's a couple months, to make updates and like make their own changes or something. And I think it's just absurd. They just need to start using Google's TalkBack. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there's some amazing reason why they think it's better this way, but I don't see why. I really don't understand. There is actually a way to remove Samsung's TalkBack and put the Google Play version. I haven't done it yet on my S22, but I'm really getting frustrated and I really do want those actions, especially on my S22. And it's just frustrating that I have to go and like do all this stuff to make it work. And Samsung, I love Samsung products, but please, could we just use Google's TalkBack? Can you just support the Google Play Android Accessibility Suite TalkBack on your devices? Seriously, this is a problem. Please fix it. Okay, rant over, I'm sorry. Those are the updates for TalkBack 13.1. Is there anything I missed? Let me know in the comments. What's your favorite update? And what are you hoping to see in the future? Let me know. Let's have a conversation about it, because I still have a list of things I want updated. Thanks so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Split tap. Oh my gosh. Split type.